Bill, want to talk about your show. Premieres today on Peacock. It's called The End Is Nye. Let's take a quick look.
Why is it that every disaster movie begins with someone in power ignoring a scientist?
People are sick of all the doom and gloom.
Because it happens more than you might think. This is gonna really It doesn't have to go down that way. Together, we can save Earth with science. Join me as I take on six world-ending disasters. Each one leading to my imminent doom.
Now that is a trailer, Bill. That's how you sell a show about science. Let's talk about some of these events that you look at to save the planet. The first one is a Hydra storm. What is that? What would it bring with it? And how do we stop it?
Well, Hydra is the multi-headed monster. So certain computer models predict you'd have multiple enormous hurricanes around the world at the same time. Four in the Northern Hemisphere, one in the Southern Hemisphere, according to some software people have carefully written. And so that would be catastrophic. So what we want to do is prepare for that. And sure enough, it's not exactly happening, but these floods in Texas, Kentucky, just shows you how difficult things get for people when we can't control enormous rainstorms. So we got to get ready for that. That's one disaster that we present.
Bill, most of what you're talking about, most of what you're going to refer to in your series that begins tonight, what we were just talking about a few moments ago, Lake Mead and the Colorado River drying up, things like that, are obvious to anybody with eyesight and common sense. But what do we do about the host, an increasingly large number of people, climate deniers? We're on the verge of having water wars in the western part of this country. What do we do about the climate deniers?
Well, this has been a problem for 30 years. But as I say, I believe now the effects of climate change are so obvious that people will come around. And when it comes to water out west, these are generally very conservative politicians managing a natural resource. And understand, in the United States, the West depends on water, it always has, and people have discussed the problems associated with drawing state boundaries on north and south lines rather than on watersheds. But that aside, we now have to manage this water, and a problem will come when it does rain again out west here, and there'll be, the ground won't have the plants, the ground cover that it would normally have. And so there'll be mudslides, and which is also very costly. Of course, it affects people's quality of life, but also it affects the economy when you can't move goods and services around on roads. And this is all easy, or it's all straightforward. But what do we do about it is what we're going to discuss in this The End Is Nigh show. And that's, by the way, climate is just one of the disasters, everybody. We got five more. We got five more world enders. And let me just point out that the Earth will be here. The Earth's not going anywhere. We want to save the environment, or preserve the environment, or conserve our resources for us humans. And this, when you state it that way, it's obvious. But what we want, everybody to work together to address these big problems through preparation. If we had these coronal mass ejections, these are streams of charged particles from the sun that could interact with the Earth's magnetic field and shut down all the electricity in the world, that would be catastrophic. But there are steps we can take to prepare for that. Just good old physics. We could prepare for that. And it requires investment, and it requires agreeing that we have a problem, and then working together to get ready for it. So everybody, check out the new series. It's different. It's a new type of show where we have a disaster, some disclosure at the end of the first half hour. I get killed.
Oh my God.
Six different ways.
Wow.
But then in the second half hour, I come back and we talk about how we can address these issues with science.
Hey, Elise, you can't kill off the star in the first act, so I'm glad they brought him back.
I know, and Bill teased five world enders, I believe, that you're going to talk about on the
six.
Well, the one I want to hear about is how do you stop a comet? That's one of your episodes.
Oh, I love that one. No, so everybody understand that I have a day job. I'm head of the Planetary Society, which started by a guy I took a class from, Carl Sagan. And we talk about this problem all the time. We'll be presenting at the Astronautical Congress in Paris in a few weeks. But coming up, everybody, we have the dual asteroid redirect test, the DART mission. So people laugh, but look, there is no evidence. In Texas, you see the dinosaur tracks in the Paluxy River. There's no evidence that the ancient dinosaurs had a space program. If they did, it wasn't good enough. And so we present the traditional ways people have proposed to give an asteroid or a comet. The nucleus of a comet is just like an asteroid. It just has more water ice. So you get a tail when it's in sunlight. I mean, it's the same, roughly the same material. Roughly could be a pun. Anyway, so what you do is you cause some of the material on the comet to eject, to ablate, to burn off. And the way you do that might be with a nuclear weapon in space. There's no sound in space. So. Or the one I like is hitting it with lasers, which is actually reasonable. Hit it with lasers and cause the surface of the comet to ablate, to burn off. And the momentum of the burning off stuff would give it a nudge. But the key to the whole thing, everybody, is finding these objects. As the saying goes, looking for an asteroid or a comet is like looking for a charcoal briquette in the dark.
Ooh.
Very difficult to see, but they do glow a few hundred kelvins above absolute zero. If you have the right instrument in deep space, you can find it. Something not the James Webb Space Telescope so much as an instrument with a spacecraft rather with similar instruments on board. And we support these missions. We go to U.S. Congress and, hey, everybody, this is a worthy investment. This is a worthy use of our intellect and treasure to keep the world from ending.
That's a worthy goal. We've got hydro storms, supervolcanoes, solar flares.
But at least, okay, as we say, low probability, high consequence. Yes, check out the other five episodes. It's already streaming on Peacock. Thank you very much for your support. Let's change the world.
Apocalyptic dust storms, comets slamming into Earth, and finally, the mother of all disasters, a ring of fire that unleashes earthquakes, tsunamis, and volcanic eruptions around the globe. But Bill Nye has the solutions. Don't worry. The new series, The End Is Nigh, premieres today. It's streaming right now on Peacock.